So right now I'm going to talk about type 4 because I'm focusing on what's called the Enneagram of Harmony. And that means that there's actually a connection between type 1, 4, and 7, 2, 5, and 8, and 3, 6, and 9. And so in the 1, 4, 7 triad, the 4 is looking for that deep emotional connection, some sort of depth of relationship, whether that relationship be, you know, in a one-on-one relationship, a relationship with an ideal way that the world should be or the way relationships should be. It could be looking for some sort of depth in a job, or, you know, the fours would even call it, you know, job seems kind of pedestrian for most fours. So some word, it would be probably more like a vocation, where fours are looking at vocation, something that matters, because fours are going to bring their idealism to work. And they're going to want work that matters. Now, the focus of attention for the four is on what is missing. So within that relationship, within that job, within the home that they're living in, the car that you're driving if you're a four, is the attention goes to what's missing. So because the assumption is that I have, you know, everybody has something that I don't have. People seem to have the car I don't have. They seem to have the relationship. And for some people, it's not a car and it's not a relationship. It could be an ideal profession. So understand that you don't want to collapse it. Well, I'm not a four if I don't long for the perfect car. Okay? What we're looking at is the focus of attention, which is on what's missing. The other thing you're going to see as a tendency with fours is something called push-pull. So as the relationship gets closer, as the ideal vocation gets closer, and now I have it, because the habitual attention in the brain is on what's missing, that's going to be what the four is going to start to notice. And so you might find that somebody longed for you and now you're here. All of a sudden, you're not quite as interesting, and you really kind of, your clothes are a little boring, and maybe the way your hair is kind of ordinary. And fours working on themselves start to notice that this is just a habit. So this is the push-pull strategy. And then when you're away, one four told me that her husband said to her, it seems like you love me most when I'm out of town. And so that's kind of how this strategy works itself out. Because the attention when you're out of town or when you're far away, you know, God, I really, really miss him. And he's just really a great guy. And we have such a great emotional connection. So that for a four working on themselves really starts to notice this attentional style. But the gift of this is fours have this way of looking at life that is deep, it is rich. They can see the beauty in the ordinary. When I was teaching in a high school, one four described, you know, I was walking down the sidewalk and I could just see the beauty in a blade of grass. Fours have this deep emotional appreciation and are much more comfortable with emotions like fear and anger and melancholy and sadness than other types might be. So what's interesting is that fours who have some self-awareness start to realize that this is a pattern. And it's a pattern that doesn't always, you know, really work. And when they start to soften that pattern, something else emerges. And that is balance and equanimity. And that's actually the gift that fours bring to the world. Because they've kind of ridden the emotional roller coaster, as one four told me, the toilet bowl swirl of my emotions. They've been riding on that emotional roller coaster, and they start saying, you know, there's something missing in that. And there's actually something that's deeper underneath. And there's a kind of a three-center balance, an emotional equanimity, where I can see things with some sense of clarity and precision, like the one. I can kind of expand in some way to the joy that is inherent, you know, in this world. And I can be really present with myself and another in emotional depth. So you can see how sometimes the challenge of our type is actually the gift that we end up bringing to the world and really what we have to teach, you know, one another. So that is type 4. And the next type I'm going to be talking about is type 1 in that, you know, Enneagram of Harmony.